intentions of our hearts be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. David and I have a cat. She's named Mary Magdalene, but we call her Maggie. And like most cats, Maggie is pretty wonderful. She only speaks cat, but she does know quite a bit of English. Like, do you want to go outside? It's time for bed. Now, Maggie is also very organized. She puts the red toys under the washing machine and the yellow toys under the refrigerator. She's also a cat of routine. If we're home at 4 o'clock, she tells us it's time to eat. And then after her meal, she curls up in the office chair by the window to soak up the afternoon sun. Because that's, after all, that's what cats do, right? Eat, sleep, and play. It's sort of a mission statement for cats. Today, our gospel gives us a mission statement, a mission for Jesus and the church. And this comes from Luke, the author who also wrote the book of Acts. The book tells us how the early church was formed. But today, we hear of Jesus' first recorded act of ministry in Luke. You may remember that last week, we heard John tell us of Jesus' first public ministry at the wedding of Cana. But in Luke, we're told that Jesus has been doing ministry for a while. A report about him spread through all the surrounding country. But this, today's gospel, is the first narrative with specifics. Luke begins Jesus' ministry by telling us what Jesus' ministry is, what his mission statement is. In the synagogue, we're told Jesus stood up to read. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written. Jesus found. Jesus chose this particular passage specifically to announce his ministry. He quotes from the book of Isaiah, specifically from chapter 61, which is often called the Suffering Servant. After reading, Jesus gives what may be the shortest ever sermon. Here's Jesus' sermon. Today, this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing. Amen. Now, I know you'd like it if mine were that short, but unfortunately, meaning that Jesus' ministry is to proclaim release to the captive and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor. Jesus couldn't have been any more succinct than that. It is clear what he has come to do. The people of Israel have waited centuries for the fulfillment of promises that God made throughout their history, beginning with Abraham. And now Jesus declares, the wait is over. Salvation is nigh. The fulfillment of Scripture does begin with the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. But it continues in the life of the church today. Specifically, it is continuing here at Christ Church. It continues because the Holy Spirit is upon us as the Holy Spirit was upon Jesus. We too are anointed with the Holy Spirit. And while this past year has been a bit of a struggle, you've come through it with flying colors. And I believe it is because you have put your faith, your trust in the Holy Spirit to empower you, to carry you through the darkest of days, the uncertainty of the times. 2021 was actually a tremendous year for Christ Church. In so many ways, you grew and flourished. I hope that you will take time to read this year's annual reports. They contain page after page of fulfillment of our mission statement, knowing Christ and making him known. In other words, they contain page after page of proclaiming the year of the Lord's favor, release to the captive. For instance, we've added so many new families, we now have a children's minister. We now worship in a variety of ways, whether it's in person, online, or in the parking lot, meeting the varied needs of our community. Our technology has greatly improved as we're willing to spend our resources to open avenues for participation. Being back in person has allowed us to bring back the adult forum, which exceptionally strong offerings. We've added new programs and ministries. Our finances look healthy. Our generosity continues to grow. In addition to racial reconciliation work, you've started a community garden. That's a huge undertaking that is successful only because of your participation. Now, these days, it's difficult to count attendance with online members, whom we love, but it does muddy the picture a little bit. So the church, worldwide, is looking at new ways to determine growth. And the direction seems to be moving into analyzing discipleship. Now, you may wonder, how is discipleship determined? The number one factor is, how does a congregation steward? How are you giving of your time, talent, and treasure? So how is Christ Church doing? Well, look around at the folks who have joined us this past year. Even Bishop Ryan noted the number of new leaders among us. And did you hear how many of you increased your pledge? And how about our outreach goals that you blew past every time, whether it was backpacks or boxes of macaroni and cheese? I look around, and I see strong disciples, folks hungry and willing to know Christ and make him known. Now, last year in our annual report, I said that we had more to do. I said, quote, "There is a new rector to call, a capital campaign to relieve the debt, children's ministry, online presence, a youth mission trip, and more community work to be done." Well, did you look at that and listen to that? While we may have been hampered by the pandemic, we have made significant progress, including our children's ministry and online presence. We have done some community work in spades. Our youth are looking forward to going to New Orleans this summer on their mission trip. And the vestry is currently doing some free work on a debt-relieving capital campaign that really does need a rector to finalize. Your search committee has spent countless hours discerning who your next rector will be. So please keep them in your prayers and in your gratitude. Because the truth is, you are going to call a rector who will love you, and who will be a faithful pastor who will care for you and equip you for your ministries. All in all, I think that Christ Church is in a strong position. You are poised to grow. You are growing. You are following Jesus' call to proclaim to the recovery of sight of the blind. Jesus' mission statement is yours, and you are fulfilling it extremely well. It amazes me how resilient, how joyful, how strong you are. You took a pretty crappy year and made it a year of growth, of extending the kingdom of God. You found new ways to proclaim the good news, to know in Christ and make him known. I hope that you will find strength in what you have accomplished, and you will use it to continue the work. This is weird. All of a sudden, I'm ready to cry. I just want to tell you, I'm really honored and pleased to say that I'm serving at Christ Church and Temple, because you are a beautiful parish, literally and figuratively, filled with loving, faithful people who are centered around our mission statement. I apologize. So congratulations on a great year. May 2022 be even better. And as our colleague says, give us grace, O Lord, to answer readily the call of our Savior Jesus Christ and proclaim to all people the good news of his salvation. Amen. Amen.